In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use PaintShop Pro X5 to create a photo collage that will fit as your Facebook timeline cover. I'll introduce techniques that you can use for any photo collage project, whether you're creating something for the web or print. I'll use layers to arrange several photos and apply photo effects, a picture frame, text, and other embellishments. Of course, you can place any size photo or graphic as your Facebook timeline cover and adjust to just what you want to show, but let's start with that size in mind, so everything you want in your photo will be visible in the timeline cover. Let's get started. We'll start with a blank canvas instead of just opening a photo, so we'll be able to set the exact size we need. Start by going to File, New. The dimensions of a Facebook timeline cover are 851 by 315 pixels. I'm also going to set the background to be transparent. I have a folder open of photos and objects I've collected to use in my timeline cover. You can get backgrounds and objects from a variety of sources, including the internet, clip art collections, and stock photo sites. There are several ways to transfer images from one window or file to another. Let me open the background image I want to use first. Notice I now have two tabs at the top that represent my two open files, the new file and this background image. You can select, copy, and paste the background into the new file, or you can try this. Grab the layer of the one you want to move and hover it over the tab of the one you want to add it to. That tab will then come to the front, and then simply drop the image onto it. Now though, because of the original image size, this image is so big in comparison to the background, I can't see the outer edges of it. To fix this, I'll use my mouse wheel to zoom out until I see the outer edges of the background image, and now I can resize it to fit better, and then zoom back in. Since it's a design graphic, I can skew it a little bit, and it'll still look good. I'll even let it overhang somewhat, but only what's on the canvas will be visible. Another method is to resize the image first, which I'll do with this first photo, using Image Resize. Another method is to use the Scale tools in the property bar. Next, I'll turn off tabbed documents so I can see multiple windows at the same time. Again, I can either select the photo and copy and paste, or even easier, just drag the layer to the new window like this. I'll use this method to add the other two photos I'm using too. You'll notice that as I place each new photo, PaintShop Pro places each on a new layer as indicated here in the Layers palette. This will be very helpful as I'll be able to edit and rearrange each object without affecting anything else, like this. You can also create new layers on your own for the same purpose. This is a good time to save our file into the PaintShop Pro format. The .psp image format will retain all my layers as editable, so I can still make any changes I'd like. Let's add a picture frame to one of these photos. I'll select the layer with the two children and go to Image, Picture Frame. I'll choose daguerreotype and make sure I apply this only to the objects on this layer. On the bottom photo layer, I'll add a photo effect. So let's go to Effects, Photo Effects, Black and White Film. I'll start by using a color filter. This mimics exactly what would happen if one were to use a color filter with black and white film. Going from one side of the color wheel to the other produces the opposite contrasting filter effect. I'll settle on an orange filter and set the brightness to around mid-40s and clarity to the low 20s. You'll notice that again, the effects are only applied to the selected layer. I'll even rotate it a little bit. For the third photo, let's apply a Retro Lab effect, located under Effects, Photo Effects, Retro Lab. I'll select a preset from one of the many available, but I'll leave all the other controls at their default settings, and click OK. Other effects can be applied through layer styles. How about adding a small drop shadow? I can set the shadow using the joystick and/or using precise measurements. Since I would like to apply the same shadow to the other photos, I'll save this one as a preset, making it easier to apply to the others. Great, this is coming along nicely. I now want to add the Statue of Liberty, but just the statue, not the sky. For this, I'll use the Background Eraser tool. How this cool tool works is that I click the nub in the middle on the area I want to delete, but make sure the circle overlaps the area I want to keep. PaintShop Pro will then do the rest. It helps that the background has a decent contrast between it and the foreground. The circle can be interactively adjusted using the Alt key. If you need additional assistance using it, remember to refer to the Learning Center, which will display instructions whenever a tool is selected. When done, I'll move it over to the main image, place it just above the background layer, and move it over to the left. To add an additional effect on the statue, I'll use the Blend effects in the Layers palette. These effects show various results from blending the current layer with the one underneath it. Here is one that I think looks nice for this collage. Next are the suitcases. Let's try a different method of deleting the white background. Follow along as I use the magic wand and again the layers palette. I'll need to select both portions of the white background to delete it. To do this, I can either hold the shift key and click, or choose the add mode here. Then simply click the portions I want to delete. But the white portion cannot yet be deleted because you can't delete anything from the background layer. So I will first lift my selection off the background with this layer command, Promote Background Layer, and then hit the delete key. I'll now place these in the lower right hand corner. I'm going to leave the lower left portion of my image rather empty to make room for the Facebook profile photo. Next, I'll add some custom brush strokes. Although PaintShop Pro has its own set of brushes, I happen to find these free brushes online. They happen to be made for Photoshop, but I can easily import and use them in PaintShop Pro. I'll create a new layer to put these on too, and use the paintbrush tool to place a few of these around my image. To choose another brush, simply double-click it in the brush list. I'll set one to rotate around 340 degrees using the property bar. I'll even change the color of the wavy lines one. I'll use the Alt key again to scale down the one for the suitcases, and then add a couple more. Lastly, I'll add a bit of text. And we're almost done. Let's not forget to keep saving in the PaintShop Pro file format. All I have to do now is place it into Facebook, which I'll do by first saving it as a JPEG, which will merge all of our layers down into one. A JPEG can be saved using File, Save As, or File, Export, JPEG Optimizer. But since Facebook optimizes the JPEG anyway, I'll just do a Save As. And there you have it. If you need more information, check out the PaintShop Pro help files, or explore the Corel guide for additional resources and tutorials.